Hi! Welcome back to the fort. We're trying to solve a problem. See, we're all going on vacation together at the lake. Juniper was going to join us by using Squeaks' toy boat to float along, but Squeaks can't find the boat. We decided to think like engineers as we try to solve this problem. We decided to build a raft for Juniper. We looked around the fort to find some things we could use.
And I'm ready to start designing my raft. So, how exactly should I do that? I've never designed a boat before.
Ah, good questions. One thing an engineer does when they design a solution to a problem is what we're doing right now.
We're not really doing anything, though.
Except standing around talking.
And that's it, Sam. Engineers talk to each other. They share ideas about the problem, just like we did. Do you remember what we said when we talked about how our raft needed to solve our specific problem? We worked together to come up with three things.
That's right, Squeaks. It needs to be able to float, and I need to be able to fit on it and stay safe.
So, when we design our rafts, we need to keep those things in mind. Let's take a good look at our materials and then draw designs for our rafts. We have a kitchen sponge, some craft sticks, cardboard paper, a ball of modeling clay, some aluminum foil and corks, and a big flat rock. Let's think about these materials and how we could use them in our designs. Oh, interesting. Why do you think the stone might or might not work? I see. Squeak says the stone is flat like a raft, so he wants to try it, but he thinks it might not work because he throws rocks in the fort's pond all the time and they always sink. That's a great observation, Squeaks. Not all of the materials we use are going to be good for making a raft. Even though the stone kind of looks like a raft and is big enough for Juniper, it sinks when we put it in water. We need something that floats, so let's try out our other things. Okay. Of the materials we tested, the craft sticks, corks, cardboard, and aluminum foil floated. So these things seem to be good things to use as part of a raft. The sponge and the paper floated for a while, but eventually sank. And the modeling clay didn't float at all. So while we might be able to incorporate these things into our raft, it has to be made mostly of something that floats. Now we know how our materials might solve our problem, so everybody can incorporate them into their designs. I'll check in with our other friends and see how their designs are coming along, while Squeaks, you can go ahead and draw your design. Here's Dino's design. He drew a paper airplane for Juniper to fly on so that she's far above the water. And he included a big fan to help keep the plane in the air. But I see a few potential reasons this design might not work. Do you? I think that if the paper airplane does land in the water, it would probably get soggy and sink. Plus, we'll be outside by the lake with nowhere to plug a fan in. It looks like Bill and Webb are still arguing over what's more important, the size of the raft or having handholds for safety. Their designs both put a lot of emphasis on the things they think are more important. I think maybe we can find a balance between these two ideas. But it looks like everybody else is done drawing, so let's see what they came up with. Juniper, your design looks great. Why don't you tell us how it works?
I drew a picture of a raft made of aluminum foil. When we tested the aluminum foil, it floated. I made it big enough for me to curl up inside, and it has sides so I don't fall out.
That definitely seems like it might work. Squeaks, what did you come up with? Nice job, Squeaks! You drew a picture of a raft made of craft sticks. And there's a handle in the middle for Juniper to use. How about you, Sam?
Here's my design. My picture shows a raft made out of cardboard. It's got corks on the bottom of it, so it floats really well. Plus, it has a sail.
Ooh, it looks very stylish. You know what I like about these designs? They all show how they will solve our problem. Sam's design shows that the corks will help it float. Juniper's is the right size, and Squeaks has a nice handle for safety. Those are the main things we decided our design would need to do. What's next? Great question. We have a lot of designs, but we'll probably build just one raft.
Then how do we decide which one is best?
The same way engineers do. We'll each build our designs. Then, we'll test them to see which one solves our problem the best.
That sounds like fun!
It will be! Let's get building, and then we can test our designs. Come back next time to do some more thinking like an engineer. And if you want to have fun with me, Squeaks, and all our friends, you can subscribe to SciShow Kids, and we'll see you next time here at the fort.